The Philippines seeking the assistance of the Czech Republic in defense technology. During a meeting with Czech Prime Minister Petr Fiala, Marco said technology transfer is part of his administration's continued support for the modernization of the Philippine military. He hopes the two countries can cooperate on that front. Marcos also met with the Prime Minister of the Netherlands, Mark Rutte. Now the two sides agreed to bolster ties, particularly in defense as well as water management. In other news, Philippine Chief Justice Alexander Hesmundo insists he never raised the possibility of the High Court reopening the Marcos estate tax case after it issued a final ruling on the matter. Hesmundo gave the clarification at the Supreme Court's year-ender briefing. He said he was referring to the finality of judgments in general and not on the Marcos family's unpaid estate taxes, which he earlier commented about Supreme Court decisions not being written in stone. The Chief Justice also said the High Court's decisions are expected to be certain and predictable, except in rare instances.
Ang desisyon ng korte, nakasulat sa bato. Para maburo yan, mahirap yan. Kaya nung sumunod kong statement, napakasimple. There are rare instances where the decision can be changed. Yung judicial philosophy na pwedeng mabago kasi nagbabago ang korte ng komposisyon. Sinabi ko, diba? Meron mga liberal na dumadating, may conservative. Hindi ibig sabihin nun, papalit-palit ang desisyon.
The Philippine Supreme Court ruled in 1997 that the family of the late President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. owed the Bureau of Internal Revenue some 23 billion pesos in estate taxes. The court said this was based on the Bureau's 1991 assessment. The order became final and executory in 1999. Internal Revenue Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. says the Bureau will study the matter further. Progressive lawmakers are calling for a congressional probe into the alleged abuses committed by Pastor Apollo Quibuloy against women and children in the Philippines. This as he faces sex trafficking charges in the U.S. In a resolution, the Makabayan Bloc said the legislature cannot afford to stand idle in the face of mounting allegations against the religious leader.
Actually, hindi ito call sa ano lang eh. Sa Congress anon of the Philippines. Ito po ay call even sa Ferdinand Marcos Jr. administration right now. Kailangan po no na mabigyan ng hustisya yung mga biktima, hindi lang dun sa US, maging dito sa Pilipinas. Kung very powerful po or in the authority yung person na yon, dapat sino ba yung mga backers noon? Baka naman kailangan nating pag-usapan yon at hence the necessity for an investigation.
But Quibuloy's lawyer asserts Congress is not an investigative body.
Hindi po pwede yung legislative investigations na substitute for what one feels to be a lack of action on the part of the executive. At kung yan ay gagamitin mo upang i-pressure ang executive na to act in the manner in which you believe they should act, yan po ay paglabag sa prinsipyo ng separation of powers. Wala namang iniisip na legislation yung si Arlene. Walang iniisip yan. Gusto lang yan ay mag-grandstanding